Hi everyone. In this video, let's learn about an online real-time collaborative tool which can be really helpful for online classes. So this is going to be really helpful for school students, college students, as well as teachers all over the world. So it is called a Zyteboard, which is nothing but Zoomable Whiteboard. And you don't need any apps or plugins for using this online whiteboard. You just have to sign up, okay? And it is very simple and easy to understand tool for online learning. And it is specifically optimized for Chrome as well as the Safari web browser. So to just get started, go to your web browser and type google.com. Okay, in Google, just type Zyteboard. So you will get to see a link from Zyteboard.com. Just click on that link. So here in the dashboard for Zyteboard.com, you'll have an option called Start Drawing Now. Just click on that. Now this is your dashboard for Zyteboard.com. Okay, so first thing is just click here the three lines which appear on the left hand side. So what is the first thing which you're supposed to do is you need to sign up. Okay, you can sign in by using your Google account or by using your Facebook account. Or else you can also sign up by using any of your existing email IDs and you can create your own account in Zyteboard. So here already I have created an account. All you have to do is just give your email ID and give your set up a password for your account. And a verification mail will be sent to your Gmail ID. And from there on, you can verify your email ID and then you can sign up by using that user ID and password. Okay, so already I have created an account here. On the left hand side, you can see the different types of options available. So first option is create new board. You cannot create a new board without signing up. Okay, you have to sign up to create a new board. So, and then you have options to save your board. Once you have all the contents of your board, online whiteboard, then you can save the contents of your board. So in the Zyteboard's basic version, you can save up to 3 boards. So if you want to save more, then you have to go in for the pro version. Okay, all your saved boards will appear here in the My Boards tab. And then you can invite people by using this invite tab. Okay, so you can invite people to collaborate. As I told you, it's an online real-time collaborative tool. That is, you can invite your students to come and collaborate. So whatever contents you write on the whiteboard, they can edit the contents. They can also collaborate and provide their input to the contents of the online whiteboard. So if you don't want your participants to collaborate, you just want them to view the contents of the whiteboard, then you can use this option wherein this share to view option will generate a link. That link, you can share it with your participants and the participants will only be able to view the contents of your whiteboard. They will not be able to edit it. It also provides you the option to, in the whiteboard, you can insert an image or a PDF or an MP3 file by uploading it. Okay, and then here let's get on to create a new board. So I click on the create new board option and I give the name for my board. Okay, so here you can give the option as if you create the board by using view only mode, then except the owner, nobody else will be able to edit the contents of the whiteboard. So here I'm just creating a new whiteboard. Now I have created it. So here you can see that on the left hand side, you have different types of options. You have 3 basic colors available, black, blue, and red. And you have fonts of different sizes here. And then you have, this is for font thickness. This indicates you can create fonts of 3 different types of thickness here. And this is your pen tool. Okay, so let me show you some certain samples. So I click on black color and then I click on this one. Next, I click on blue color and then I click on this one. Next, I click on red color and then I click on this font size. Next, I click on red color and then I click on this one and then I click on this one. Okay, these are some of the samples available. Then you have the pen tool here. So here also you have the same set of samples here. You can also draw shapes here. This is line, this is rectangle, and this is circle. So I have clicked on the rectangle tool and the red color is being selected. I have clicked on the circle tool here. Then I clicked on the line tool here. Okay, this is your pen panel. In this pen panel, you can create fonts of different sizes. You can create freehand sketches. You can create free style fonts, as well as you can also create typed fonts like this. To create typed fonts like this, you just type a dot and then you can type in the text from your keyboard. So followed by the pen panel, you have the eraser. Now I click on the eraser. And then I can rub in the contents. Okay. Now this is followed by your insert tab. So in this, if you click on this insert, you can see that you can paste a link from the web, or you can choose any file from your device by using this choose file option. Okay. Then the fourth option is to add sticky notes. You can add sticky notes or you can add to-do notes. I just click add to-do notes. So a to-do note has been pasted here. Okay, similarly, you can also paste sticky notes like this. Okay, you can add sticky notes and you can write in some contents inside the sticky notes. The next one is you have your selection tool. With the selection tool, you can select a list of options. You can select a particular area and then you can delete it. Okay, I have now selected it by using the select option and then I click the delete button. Everything is being deleted. Okay, now this is your move option. Using this move option, you can move your canvas. See here, now I'm moving the canvas by clicking on the move option. Okay, that's why it is called as a collaborative, editable, zoomable whiteboard. Okay. Now this is your undo and redo options. This is undo and this is redo. And this is your zoom, maximize, and this is your minimize button. So I click on the maximize. You can see that it's getting maximized. Then I click on the minimize. You can see that it's getting minimized. Then I click on home button. It is getting resized to its initial position. Okay. So here also you get some options like you can invite people by creating a link. A link gets created when you click on this invite option. Using that link, you can share the link with your participants, with your students, with your friends, and you can collaborate and have an online class. Okay, apart from this, you can see here that all the boards which you have created here will be saved here. In the basic version, it allows you to save up to 3 boards and all the boards are saved by default. Okay, so here you can see that if you want to close the board, you also have the close board option. So finally, you can end up by closing the board. You can also export your whiteboard. You can share the contents of your whiteboard. So some of the features you could have understood now that it has a zoomable user interface, and the Zyteboard gets you permanent shareable whiteboards, and as well as all boards created are automatically saved. You can save up to 3 boards. So that's all about Zyteboard. Hope you find it useful. See you in my next video. Thank you.